The biggest issue with the VVTi timing gear is that seal inside eventually breaks down and gets hard and it leaks oil everywhere. So that's usually the main cause of your oil leaks on the timing side. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So if you guys see my recent videos, I did the timing belt service and all that on this car. And just for the sake of saving time, because I didn't want that video to be like 45 minutes to an hour long, I decided to separate some of the different components up. So on this episode today, what I'm going to show you is how to rebuild the VVTi cam gear. So the cam gear that comes from Toyota is not serviceable. They don't want you servicing it because of some laser alignments in it that people can mess up on. Plus the labor time it takes to take it open and change the seal in it, it's probably cheaper to have the technician just replace the timing gear, because most of your time is just trying to take apart everything just to get that cam gear out. So today I'll show you how to rebuild it on the cheap. It's about $25 worth of parts and it only takes like maybe 10 to 15 minutes to really do it. But you just gotta be careful on some things, so stay tuned. The biggest issue with the VVTi timing gear is that seal inside eventually breaks down and gets hard and it leaks oil everywhere. So that's usually the main cause of your oil leaks on the timing side. So you can see there's a pool of oil just sitting right there from those leaks. With this whole timing gear, it's pretty much kept on by 5 bolts, and the bolts have a little tolerance in them. But from the factory, those are actually laser aligned exactly, so your timing is exactly perfect and you don't mess up anything. So before you even take it apart, you gotta make sure that you mark all your timing parts, especially, you know, you use that little groove right here to do that. And then you gotta put together exactly within millimeters of that spot so you don't lose timing on this and screw up your engine. And this rebuilding of the timing gear is best to do it during the timing belt service, just because you gotta take all this stuff apart already when you're doing it. You gotta remove this 14 millimeter hex here. So not many people have 14 millimeter hex bolts. So you kinda got, like for me, I'm gonna rig it with a bolt, the back of a bolt and 2 nuts to try to get it back in place. And the factory manual actually tells you to get inside the valve cover. You see this little hex right here. So you put an adjustable wrench there and then you hold it back there while you're turning this so you don't turn and take this thing out of time. Or you could probably try to shoot it off with an impact. So I'll try to do it the way the factory manual says. Let's see if this works. I had to rig this little thing for some leverage. That way I could put all my weight on here. Oh yeah. So now we're gonna get down to actually doing this disassembly and putting the new seal in. You can't really mess this thing up, because once you take this thing out, all the gears inside all go in one way. You can't really screw that up. The thing that you can screw up is the timing. So you gotta look at these marks right here. So there's a mark there and then there's a circle here. So you wanna, before you start, you wanna score those little spots using a little screwdriver or something sharp. So you can score a line in there and then maybe even score and make that hole. So when we put it back together, we just line those 2 spots together and bolt it down. So I'll go ahead and find a little screwdriver and do that right now. You just look into there, kind of score the side that, and it's, you know, it's pretty dirty. You're not gonna screw it up that bad, so I scored along there, and I also scored the wall. So that way I have a reference point laid inside the groove and then along the wall. And then over here I'm just gonna go, I'm gonna take the thing and just scratch it and circle it. You know, with it being so dirty on most of these, by the time you guys are rebuilding these, it'll be pretty obvious when you take it apart where it goes. So we'll go ahead and, you know, I just keep on doing this just to make good work of it. Once you get that, so you gotta take apart these 10 millimeters. So these are your just normal 10 millimeter bolts that are probably torqued on like 9 pounds. So I'm just gonna use my little impact driver. And this is only to remove it. You don't wanna impact drive it on. You got it, so you just take it apart. So yeah, it's pretty easy. A couple weeks ago when I actually looked, it's August 2020 right now. This thing was only 130 bucks on eBay from all the, you know, reputable sellers of OEM parts. Some of the Lexus dealers were selling them for like close to $200, but then within the last 2 weeks, the price has jumped up to $155. So the price has gone up 20-something dollars in the last month or so since I looked at it. A lot of those guys always price match each other on eBay anyways, but I find it odd that it jumped that much in price. But the dealer, yeah, the Bell Lexus, the dealer that I buy from all the time, their price is $230. So doing this, you're gonna save at least $130. This part shipped was like $23. And then just the labor to do this. So now that I've unbolted everything, I put my bolts off to the side. If it doesn't come off right away, then you probably wanna take something and tap it, because you know, it's been in here for 18 years, so I gotta go find a little socket and tap it through the back. So one other thing, you could set it on two blocks of wood along here and just get something that fits right in the center and then tap it out. But maybe I'll do that since I have all these blocks of wood around here. You want to turn the other way, so you want the face down. Make sure you just line it up so it's only touching the gears. Only the outer shaft, and then just get something that fits in here. Since I'm doing my timing belt service, I've got this 22 millimeter, which fits in there like a glove, and then just tap it right through. Just a light tap, and it drops right through. So you want to flip it over, pull it apart now, and you can see. Once you take it apart, a lot of times the seal gets stuck on this side, on the sprocket side, but mine actually came out on the over here on this side, so that's a good sign, I guess, if it's a little bit easier to take off because it's not in the groove. But let me see what, you just wanna, yeah, this thing is solid as a rock in here, man. This thing, 18 years, is probably gonna brittle and cracked. Yep. So this thing is a big culprit for leaking on 2JZ engines with VVTi. I mean, look at that. Now, once you peel that off, you just want to take it apart, clean it, and like I said earlier, the gears, they just drop right out, and yeah, you don't have to worry about it getting back in place because they only come in, go back in one way, so there's no way to screw this up. Because yeah, you basically, if you look at the grooves, there's some flat edges on here, and then you look at on this side, and there's another flat edge, and it just lines up. Once you line up those flat edges, it just falls right in. So important that you keep this place clean, this area clean, because you're gonna wipe it up, and then you're gonna end up putting it back on a dirty piece of cardboard or table. So I'm just gonna wipe the excess oil with my rag, and then once I do that, I'm gonna use my brake parts cleaner and a clean rag to just clean everything up in here. While cleaning it out, there's inside here, there is a rubber seal in here that it's not a part that seals anything. I think it's more of a gasket, but it's in here. So just be careful not to damage that or spray that with anything that might damage it. So we'll take some brake parts cleaner. Just I usually just drizzle it on lightly. So just to get the chemical onto there, I don't need the aerosol, the high jet aerosol in here. Let it sit for a little bit and then kind of work his magic, especially in the groove on this side where the new seal is gonna go. So yeah, all the years of leaking oil through here, you can see where it kind of penetrated through here and got along the lines and all that there over here. So what I'm gonna do, since I have my Scotch-Brite that I've been just scrubbing everything with a Scotch-Brite, I'm gonna go ahead and just scrub some of this. I'll probably just grab a new piece so that way I don't introduce any more contaminants in here. But yeah, I just, because I want my mating surfaces to be just free of all this oxidation and corrosion over the years. Got a little piece of Scotch-Brite. I'm just gonna go around the edges of this. And circular, the same, there's like, this is factory scoring from the machining. Just follow that pattern. Some little pieces of rubber still left in here from peeling that gasket off. So yeah, you just want to get that mating surface perfectly smooth. No kind of gaps or anything that might cause a leak when the new seal comes on. So I got that done. Even though I did all this, I still see the scoring marks from when earlier when I did that there and here. The ones on the wall kind of disappeared a little bit. I basically know where it's supposed to be, so I'm good there. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna hit it both surfaces with some more brake parts cleaner. So we wanna reassemble the gear over here. So putting the gear back up together, it's pretty simple. It kind of goes one way, but there is a way you could fuck this up, right? So this, if you look at the gear, one side is got, it doesn't go all the way to the end. So make sure that it goes upside down so you don't see that goes inside. It will go on either way, so you gotta be very careful. The easiest way to do it is to make sure that you see the notches. So there's a notch here, and a notch down here, and then you just line those notches up and it falls in. So yeah, you gotta make sure that's going in that direction, because if you put it the other direction, you're gonna get the P1349 code once you put it in. It'll still work and run, but the movement won't be as smooth and you won't get your full 30 degree rotation. So that it's important that you do that. So pay attention to this part when you're putting that back together. Other than that, everything else is pretty simple. Line on, when you're putting it back here, line it up on the outside so you can see the mark on the outside. And just line it up. And then get it in there. So once it's in there, you can just leave it, set it off to the side. If you want to wipe the excess oil or grease and dirt, you could do that. Just kind of keep it clean for now. And then we got to stretch the new gasket. So we got to put some oil on here and stretch it. So dip it in oil, so you just get some fresh oil. All I have is this big old jug, so I'm just gonna dip it in there, just get a little bit on there. Don't drop it in here. Kinda, so put it all around the seal, coat the seal really well, and start stretching it. So the key to this is stretching it. Don't stretch too much, but you gotta put some strength into it. And you gotta get it to form to the size of this spot, and then once you get it formed, you only have about 20 seconds to get the other thing in there, or else it's gonna shrink back down. So you gotta get it in there, flip that thing around, use your pinky to hold the gear in, and then get it in there to where your alignment marks were. The reason why you have to get it alignment marks, because inside the gear, once you get this in, there is a small tolerance from the factories. I'm just threading them on right now by hand just to hold it, but we want to get some Loctite on them before we lock them down. So there, I got them tightened hand. I'm gonna get a ratchet now and make sure they're all fully seated and tightened. Got out the torque wrench just to be legit. So all my scores and notches are good. I'm gonna go ahead and set this thing up. So they all clicked. So I'm good now. I'm gonna wipe it down. And hey guys, thanks for watching all the way to the end of this short video on rebuilding this VVTi cam gear with the new seal in it. As you can tell, it's a pretty simple process. You know, the 5 bolts, put that seal in, put it all back together. As long as you follow the directions and mark where your existing cam gear is and you put it back the way it was before, you should be fine, and it's gonna save you upwards of $200 if you had to go buy this from an online dealer, or if you buy one from one of the eBay sellers who are selling it for like $150, $160 as of this video right now. That's still $130 savings using that drift motion kit. If you're watching this video, you're probably doing a timing belt and water pump service. So don't forget to check out my other video where I go into detail about taking all this stuff apart on here and putting it all back together and doing the whole timing belt and water pump service on this car. So check that video out. I'll have a link up here. If you like this video or you found it informative, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to your channel already, go ahead and subscribe to your channel. And if you want these cool shirts, check out the Teespring store. I'll have a link up here. And I'll talk to you guys next time in the next video.